Hello and welcome to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. In the last tutorial, I mentioned that algorithms should be efficient, especially when we are working with large inputs. But how do we actually know if an algorithm is efficient? One way is by looking at its time and space complexity. So today's topic is time and space complexity. These are two key ways we measure how efficient an algorithm is. Here, complexity is a term from theoretical computer science that captures the effort required to solve a problem. Time complexity means effort in time. Space complexity means effort in memory. Alright, first let's talk about time complexity. Time complexity tells us how the running time of an algorithm increases as the size of the input increases. Time complexity is measured by counting the number of basic operations an algorithm performs relative to the size of the input, usually represented as n. We use big O notation to describe time complexity. It is a mathematical notation used in computer science to describe the efficiency of an algorithm. Big O notation is a way to describe the upper bound or worst case performance of an algorithm as the input size grows. Here we can see few examples. Time complexities. It is the constant time, logarithmic time, linear time, log linear time, and quadratic time. Big O measures growth rate, not exact speed. Okay, so this is about time complexity. Next, let's talk about space complexity. Space complexity is a way to measure how much extra memory an algorithm needs to run depending on the size of the input. Just like time complexity focuses on how runtime grows with input size, space complexity focuses on how memory usage grows. Big O notation is used to describe the space complexity. It is the constant space, linear space, quadratic space, and logarithmic space. Okay, so this is about space complexity. Next, let's take an example, a simple program. Here we have our program. And here, let's calculate the time complexity and space complexity of this program. To calculate the time complexity, first list each line or block of code. Next, analyze each block of the code. Then add times of sequential block. And then keep the dominant terms. Ignore constant terms and lower order terms. Okay, so here, this is the first line, second line, third line, fourth line, and fifth line of our program. You can treat this as one block, for loop and its body, like this. And here in the first line, this is the variable assignment. Here we are assigning a variable. It is a simple operation, so it takes constant time. So we can take big O of 1. Here also, variable assignment, so constant time, big O of 1. Here we can see the for loop and its body. For loop depends on number of iterations. Here this for loop runs n times. If n is 5, it runs 5 times. If n is 10, it runs 10 times. If n is 15, it runs 15 times, right? That's why it takes big O of n. It depends on n. Next, we have print total. It is a simple operation. Here we are printing the value of total variable. So it takes constant time, big O of 1. Next, we need to add times of sequential blocks. Here we can add like this. Then we can ignore constant terms as well as lower order terms. We'll keep the dominant term. So here we'll get big O of n. This is the time complexity of this program. When analyzing time complexity, we focus on the lines of the code that are executed the most. Okay, so this is how we can calculate the time complexity. Next, let's talk about space complexity. So when calculating the space complexity, analyze the space used at each step of the program. Identify the maximum amount of memory used at any point during execution. If it uses multiple big chunks at the same time, add them together. Otherwise, just take the biggest one. Express this maximum memory usage in terms of input size. So here, first line, it is one integer number. We are storing this integer number in a variable. It takes constant space, big O of 1. Then total equal to 0. It is also an integer number. So constant space, big O of 1. Then here in the for loop, I is a variable. It holds single integer at a time. So constant space, big O of 1. And here this range function. Here range is a generator like object. It uses constant space, so big O of 1. Then total equal to total plus I. No new variables or data structure is created here. Then we are printing this total variable, value of total variable. It won't affect computer memory. So next, we need to take the maximum memory usage. Here, big O of 1, that is the constant space. So here, the space complexity of this program is big O of 1. Little bit confusing, right? Don't worry. In the upcoming tutorials, we'll talk about time and space complexity as we discuss different algorithms. Next, why are time and space complexity important? First reason is they help you to write efficient code. Time and space complexity helps us to understand how our code performs as the input grows. Next, time and space complexity help you to choose the best algorithm. Multiple algorithms can solve the same problem. Complexity analysis helps you to compare and pick the best one. And also, with space and time complexity, you can avoid performance issue. They help you prevent bottleneck and system crashes. Okay, so this is about time and space complexity. We'll talk about this in more detail in the upcoming tutorials. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.